Council to me means a heart practice that can change people's lives.
It's the only time that you are given the peace and the quiet and the stillness to sit down and listen to each other, and listen to each other with an open heart.
I like that you can, that you're just always able to just feel good there.
Council creates that possibility of connecting with people directly, immediately, without having to already have a shared history. The shared history is our humanity. Why a circle? So we can really see each other. There's no hierarchy. Every person is on the same level. A center, because every time we gather together in a circle, there is a common relationship there. And that's why we beautify the center. We begin. We make this a special time that we say, now we're in council. We're really going to listen to one another now. Then there are the intentions of counsel. Listen from the heart, speak spontaneously, and speak leanly. These are the things we try to remember as we conduct ourselves in the council. And then the council has a closing. We have sealed this time together. It's a ceremony, what we've done together, and then we move back into the regular discourse of our daily lives.
The stories. I like listening to the stories a lot.
Nobody can bully you there because you're not allowed to talk out of turn, so no one can really bully you there.
Council is a way to relieve my stress.
I think we use a talking piece because if there wasn't a talking piece, everybody would talk at once and it would get really loud.
For me, speaking from the heart means like telling everybody what your heart thinks and how it feels.
Speaking from the heart means that when you speak, you're actually telling the truth when you speak.
Council has really helped my vision of creating a family environment and a learning environment.
This is my first year teaching. And it's been quite a challenge. You know, my students were just getting out of the seat whenever they wanted to, and they do whatever they wanted to. This class, like, buddy doesn't work, team doesn't work, cooperative learning doesn't work, nothing works. And I said, okay guys, we're just gonna have counsel today. We're not gonna learn anything. We're just gonna have counsel. When we did counsel, they all start getting the chairs, get in the circle, and they're all waiting for me. And when we get in a circle, even the one that was really disruptive all the time was sitting there and taking his turn to speak with a speaking piece. And through that counsel, I learned so much about them. They opened up to me, and I opened up to them about myself, my family. My kids feel like someone is listening to them. You know, someone cares for them. And I show them that I do care how they are. It's slowly changing in my classroom, that they no longer feel the need of running around and get my attention. And they know that sometimes you don't have to act out in order to know that you're loved. One counsel make a big difference in my class.
It's a really nice formalized way of bringing parents and teachers and students together in a meaningful way.
Let's just start with Zach and just go around.
I dedicate this council to my brother who's still in Iraq.
I can think of two very powerful experiences that I have had in facilitating councils. One of them was there were several councils going on in a classroom, and this girl had stolen over $200 from purses of the parents who had come to facilitate these councils. We went through disciplinary procedures. But then the question became, how do we bring this child back into our community after a serious incident like this? And we had a whole class council where all of the children were involved, and children were passing the talking piece to talk about their feelings associated with this event that happened. And the talking piece went around several times. And every time the girl that did this passed, until the last time, where she then looked at every single person in that circle and put her head down and said, "I'm sorry." And it was the most powerful experience I've ever had with community coming together to be able to talk about their feelings and for someone to ask for forgiveness and to bring the community back as a cohesive whole.
The batter swings and the summer flies as I look into my angel's eyes. A song plays on while the moon is high.
A man said to me once, "Tell me the truth and I'll believe. Tell me a fact and I'll remember it. But tell me your story and it'll live in my heart forever."
We're not so different from each other. In fact, we all have the same fears and the same desires and the same hopes. The same hopes to be loved and to love each other freely.
Just one person speak, everyone else listen. That's all it is. But we're all seeing each other in heart.
I guess we're big and I guess we're small. If you think about it, man, you know we got it all. Cause we're all we got on this bouncing ball. And I love you free.
Maybe if we do make an effort here, if we do take a risk, we can connect in a way that will promote a better world in the future.
There's a reason for the world. You and I.